Hey everyone, welcome back to Hardworking Man. Today we're out running chainsaws. I've got three of my favorite saws here. The Echo 501P, ported by Dino Joe. The Stihl 044, that's a classic. And then the Makita 7900, or the Sax Domar, that's also been ported by Dino Joe. We're over at Anthony's house. He was in a video a couple years ago when we came and helped him buck up a bunch of black locust trees that he had fell in his yard. He had a few more and he called me and asked me if I was interested and if I wanted to trade some maple syrup for some firewood. Absolutely. We're going to start with the Makita going after this huge black locust log. Rachel's going to help me load it into the trailer. We've got the two-man lift because these are going to be heavy. Then we'll put the Makita down and get the Echo out for this pear tree. I've never messed with pear before. I think it'll be a good smoking wood. I'm going to find out. But either way, I know it's going to be a good firewood. Another thing I'm pretty excited about is my new pants. Don't yell at me for not having chaps on because these are chainsaw pants. They're the Arborwear Dogwood. And I wanted a pair of these forever, but I couldn't justify the cost because they're not cheap. And I'm not an arborist. I don't do a lot of climbing or anything like that. I'm just a firewood guy for the most part. But they put these on sale for like $160 or $150, whatever it was. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to get a pair and try them out. And just trying them on, they're so comfortable and I love them. And as long as I don't get too hot in them, they're going to be a huge upgrade from the normal chaps I wear. I'm huffing. I should take this mic off.
How heavy is that compared to the oak?
I don't know. It's not light. Probably pretty similar.
Probably, yeah. I think that's a little heavier, right? But I'm not 100%.
The oak just rolls nicer.
Here's some big old grubs. A little bit of dirt in here. Some grubs living in it.
That's the chicken food.
For me?
Oh. That side I wasn't sure how this thing would work.
Better roll it up a ramp.
I wasn't sure how it would work, and then we used it for them oaks, and I was like, wow, that was pretty easy. Because these things aren't light by itself.
Oh.
There we go. I wanted to save that till the end. I hit a couple of dirty logs and this chain really took a hit when you hit that dirt, but I got the other two saws to still run and we're done with all the big stuff. I know, right? Oh, you tipped it. Don't hurt yourself. The trailer's full. This is a heap load of black locusts. There's a ton of BTUs in this trailer and a ton of weight. Now we got the truck backing up into the yard. There's a little bit more black locusts we couldn't fit in here. We'll throw in the truck and then down and get that pear. There it is. The NNN NO Series dump trailer is overloaded with black locust. The bed of the Silverado is filled with black locust, and then the rest is pear. Some premium firewood, some boiler wood, which we'll obviously use in our boiler, but this is an awesome load. We got to help Anthony clean up his yard and some premium firewood on top of it. The new Arborwear chainsaw pants are awesome. So much more comfortable than jeans and chaps. And running those ported saws, I've run the Echo a fair amount since it's been ported. That Makita, that's the first time I've really put some time on it since it's been ported, and it absolutely devoured that black locust. The Stihl 044 is what they always are. Classic, one of the best firewood saws out there. So if you like this type of thing, make sure to subscribe, drop a comment down below, hit a thumbs up. Thanks for watching Hardworking Man, guys, and have a great day.